is our official call to worship. I was glad when they sent unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Now we will have our morning invocational selection. Good morning. Thank you once again for being with us here at Bethsaida as we come again on Sunday to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. Happy Mother's Day to all mothers.
Yeah.
Let us at this time prepare for our opening prayer from Deacon Harvey Brown.
Good morning. Wishing all the beautiful mothers a happy Mother's Day on this beautiful day. Day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, once again we have this opportunity, the privilege to come to you in prayer, to say thank you for another day's journey. Day that we've never seen, we'll never see again, so we ask that you allow the Spirit to come down upon us, Heavenly Father, so we can do what you have helped us to do, to be right with God. Because you're God, and you're God Almighty, except that you're the creator of this universe, of all mankind, man, woman, and child. You're good God, the gracious sufficient in our lives, your mercy, and your will should be done on this earth as it is in heaven. Father God, we just thank you for being so kind and generous to us, and we want to be gracious and give you thanksgiving because we know that had it not been for you on our side, we don't know where we would be right now. This pandemic year, the beginning of another year, Heavenly Father, we've seen so much catastrophe. But we know this is all in your dynamic and divine plan, Heavenly Father. We know that something good is going to come out of it, and it should allow us all to draw closer to thee. Father, we just like to say all of y'all, thank you for being so good to us. Now, Father, we ask that you will bless our pastor this morning as he breaks into us the word of God, that we would be receptive to all things and that we would be moved to go out beyond the doors and walls of this church and tell somebody just how good God is. Let our light shine before men, that you get the praise and that you get the glory, and be mindful that we study to show ourselves approved to tell that individual who might want to know a little bit more about that Jesus, because they may come running asking, what must I do to be saved? We will surely tell them to seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things shall be added unto thee. Father God, we're a humble people today, Heavenly Father, because you allowed us to assemble ourselves and come to you and look toward the hills that's coming ahead. We come out in the morning, Heavenly Father, looking toward the heavens, because they have declared your glory and firmly showed your handiwork. Now move in us the way that you were moving us, Heavenly Father. We can't tell you how to move in us. It is you, your God, and God Almighty, except the Alpha and the Omega, beginning and the end, and all things in between. So we ask you that you would just guide us and lead us to that blessed place that you have prepared for us, and not for us to be worried about what things are going on, because you got everything in control. We will understand it better by and by. So help us to understand what you would help us to be, Heavenly Father. God, we just ask that you forgive us of our many sins and our transgressions. We ask that you go out to the other countries, Heavenly Father, and put your blessings upon those countries that's been plagued by this pandemic, Heavenly Father, knowing that it's sin that has cursed this land, Heavenly Father, but you have molded us in your image, and you remolded us, you sanctified us as we stand today, Heavenly Father, knowing the sanctification process by according to your will, we'll make partakers of your holiness. Help us to be more like thee. Let us lift up the name of Jesus, because he has said, if I be lifted up, I draw all men unto me. So, Father God, we just want to say thank you one more time and let our pastor come and break unto us the bread of life and forgive us of our many sins. For all things, Father, we just say thank you. For in the mighty name of Jesus, we do pray. And let us all say together, amen, amen, amen.
Down, you were always there to comfort me. And no one else can be what you have been to me. You will always be, you will always be the girl in my life for all time.
Mama, mama, you know
something I'd like to ask of you to share with me as I prepare by turning to John, the 19th chapter. I'd like to read for you verses 25 through 27. John, the 19th chapter, verses 25 through 27. Now, there stood by the cross of Jesus his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Cleophas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple standing by, whom he loved, he said unto his mother, Woman, behold thy son. Then said he to the disciple, Behold thy mother. And from that hour, that disciple took her unto his own home. This morning, I'd like for you to think on this thought, Behold thy mother. Behold thy mother. Our subtopic is, to a mother, love is everything. To a mother, love is everything. Again, let me say happy Mother's Day to all of you today. A beautiful day to celebrate. A day that has always been really special to the Baptist Church. It should be and has been to all churches. There are three special days that we really love to come together. First is Christmas. Second is Easter. And Mother's Day. And Mother's Day is more, to me, a sensitive and special day because a lot of the mothers that we salute and celebrate have already been called home to be with Jesus. And so I salute those who still have their mother because a mother is precious. There's nothing like a mother. I'm glad today to celebrate Mother's Day today because mothers are special. Mothers will do everything they can to provide for their child and to protect their family. Yes, there's nothing like a mother. There's nothing like the one who births you. There's nothing like the one who nurtures you. There's nothing like the one who gives you that base, that home training that prepares you for life, liberty, and also the obvious understanding of who really Jesus is. I love the text where it says, train up a child the way he should go. When he's old, he shall not depart, because most of that training does come from a mother. We thank God for our mothers. We thank them because they are special in our lives. And again, I want to remind you, there's nothing like a mother. I thank God for my mother. She's been gone roughly 17 years. But it's as if she was just with me yesterday because she's so dear to my heart and what she did for me in life and how she sacrificed for my brother and I and our family because there's nothing like a mother. I want to remind you today, as we do salute mothers, that you thank God that you had a mother, or have a mother, or had a mother experience. It could have been the grandmother raising the children. It could have been a special mother who reached out and took in a child and mothered that child. But whoever that guardian was that loved you and treats you like a mother, you need to say thank you, Jesus, and thank you, Lord. I'd like to bring to your attention some biblical accounts that can help us salute Mother's Day today. For one of the first ones comes out of Genesis that reminds us when God created heavens and earth, he created man. And then he said, man, it's not good for man to be alone. So he put him to sleep, took his rib, and he created a woman, which means from man. Are from the rib of man. And together the first man and the first woman, Adam and Eve, she conceived to him. And from that conception became the children that the Bible mentions, Cain first and Abel. There are examples They are a part of God's will. Eve is the first mother. And we need to always keep in mind that the responsibility of a mother comes from that which God created. And that is to take care of her child and to take care of her family. There's another example that's in Genesis, further in Genesis. It talks about Abraham and Sarah. And Sarah, barren, wound, could not give a child to her husband. But when God steps in, shows his love like he always has, he opened her barren womb and brought forth Isaac at the age of 90. I tell you, I got to understand that if God be for you, he's more than the world against you. But her example of motherhood has been the historical account throughout this life and this world, because from her came Isaac. And Isaac is an example of fatherhood, but also the generations of God's people who planned this earth. But there's another example I'd like to share with you about a mother, if you don't mind me saying so, that's in 1 Samuel. And 1 Samuel, somewhere around that first chapter, 26 to 28 verse, there's a story about Hannah, who had a barren womb and could not have a child. But as a mother, as I mentioned, and loves, her love is so great, she's an example of going to God, loving God, and asking God that if you would just give me a child, I give that child back to you. And as she faced the priest named Eli, she became pregnant and conceived and gave forth and brought forth a child who we know as the prophet Samuel. She fulfilled her wish. She fulfilled her obligation to serve God first as a mother by saying, I give my child back to you. And I thank God for the mothers across the land that have given their child back to God by training up a child the way he should go, by telling that child the truth and nothing but the truth, because the truth shall set you free. Thank God for mothers who give their child to God, because we know God can make a way out of no way, because we know we can't make a way without God, who is the way. And in our annual thing for the year where we state Jesus is the way, we want to keep in mind that on this Mother's Day, we salute him. We salute him for the mothers who paved the way. That brings me to the thought in our text for the hour here in John the 19th chapter, verses 25 through 27, because it's about that special time in humanity where Jesus has buried the cross and now is on a hill called Golgotha. He's been nailed to the cross, dropped low, stretched wide, hung high. And his mother never deserted him because of the love of a mother. She stands near the cross. Jesus looks down and says, behold thy mother. Asking John, who was his closest friend, to take care of my mother. And my brothers and my sisters, before I go any further, I want to remind you that we should always take care of our mother. Take care of her because of what she represents as a family. Take care of her because of what she has done for us and the sacrifice she made for her child. Take care of our mothers. And also, this also implies take care of our family, because God expects for us to take care of each other. We need to keep in mind, too, that in this episode at the cross, when he told her, behold thy mother, He was saluting her for who she was and what she had done for him. Because she is an example of love. She's an example of the love that God requires of all disciples. Because John is a disciple. And he's looking at John to express and use him as an image. The disciples are to protect one another, especially the mother. That through the church that's built upon the rock, who's Jesus, one of the missions that should always be is to protect the mothers, especially the seniors of the church, because in this world is no friend to grace. Behold thy mother, Jesus said. I remind you today that in this specific text, we need to not only represent the understanding of love, but we need to also understand that God requires all of his disciples to love one another, to love thy neighbor as thyself, to reflect God's will about loving one another as he has loved us. Because what Jesus did for us is the ultimate example of love. What Jesus did, he took on the sins of humanity. What Jesus did elevated the understanding that God is a good God. God makes ways out of no way. God prepared us to love one another, especially the mother that's an example of life that comes forth, the birth, the nurturing, the training, the protection, the security, the fulfillment of family is an example of what mother is. Thank you, Lord, for the privilege on this Mother's Day to remind us how important our mothers are, that we should salute them, not just because of their femininity and their beauty, but we salute them because of what they represent. Because a mother represents the church. For the church births new Christians as much as we can evangelize. Birth those who fall in love with Jesus because of the love Jesus has given us. The church births and brings forth new sheep to the flock, that we are responsible to tell those who don't know that except a man be born again, he shall not see the kingdom of God. The church is an example of the mother that Jesus is coming back for on that great and getting up morning. The church represents the understanding of what love is all about. Love is a willingness to help somebody. Love is the ability to protect somebody. Love is the willingness to provide for somebody. Because Jehovah Jireh, the great provider, wants the disciples to mimic him in this world as no friend to grace. Give those who don't know the understanding of the word, because the word is. But we know the word is what we need in this time such as this. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. And through the word, we can understand from the example of the mother, this woman named Mary, the mother of Jesus, this woman named Mary, who was taken in by John, a great friend, this mother who is a responsible person in a life to give protection, to give nurturing, to give love, is what we are supposed to represent. We salute our mothers today because they are the reason why we are here. And if you look back and see the examples of all what your mother has done for you, there's no way it could have been unless God had been for you. Thank the Lord for your mother. Thank the Lord for your experience that came from your mother. But I want you to understand the real person we need to thank today is Jesus, because this symbol of a mother at the cross is a symbol of the church that he left for us, that we will be able to meet him in that great and getting up morning, to live with him throughout eternity. But I must tell the rest of the story. He died on that cross and was buried in a borrowed tomb. But early on that third and appointed morning, he got up with all power in heaven and earth in his hand. And because he lives, we can face tomorrow. Thank you, Lord, for Mother's Day. But mostly thank you for Jesus, who gave us a mother. Because the love of a mother is the greatest experience outside of the love of Jesus than anybody could ever have. There's nothing like a mother. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. On this day, we salute our mothers. We ask that the love of God would surround them, that you would put your love and arms of protection around them for wherever they are, and to thank the mothers that have gone on home to be with you in glory. Remember, my brothers and my sisters, I always thank God for his goodness and his glory that can be seen through a mother. We open the doors of the church that someone will give their hand to humanity, but give your heart to God. And if I can be of a counseling source to encourage you to be a part of God's church and fully understand his salvific story as you receive him, to receive your salvation, to be saved, take note and we'd be happy to serve you. Thank you. bless us today. If I ask of you to support us with your tithe and your offering, we ask now that you would consider us as a missionary Baptist church as we continue to serve God with our mission and our programs at this church to help somebody along the way. Thank you for whatever you can do. Let me remind you too, the next Sunday at this church, Bethsaida Baptist Church, we're going to come back in personal fellowship for the first time in 14 months. We're going to abide by the standards and the requirements, but we want to encourage you to come. Sunday school will be at 9:30. Services will be at 10 o'clock. We'll be saluting women once again with our Women's Day. We hope and pray you can join us. We hope and pray you will pray us up. We hope and pray that you will be blessed further on this day, having been blessed because of Mother's Day. Bethsaida members, you know we've been honored through the efforts of Sister Ivy Barksdale, our church secretary, who has produced a newsletter, a church newsletter, for the last months that we depend on for information, help us to understand, keep us in touch, and also further educate us on the requirements of discipleship. And look at it this Tuesday and Friday, that is going to give the particulars that are required of us to come back in personal fellowship. Please be prepared. Wear your mask. Please be prepared, because we will be social distancing. Please be prepared to abide by the rules. And thank you for your support. God bless. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.